Good morning and welcome to Chapel on this Thursday morning. We're happy to have you with us. Today is a big day in Chapel. We have lots of people here. So special thanks to Evan, Maddie, and Diana for their messages this morning and for Habitat for Humanity for their leadership this morning. They'll be sharing what went on the spring break trips that Habitat went on 2 weeks ago. So we're really excited for that. Also special thanks to Mannerchor for their musical offering this morning and for Dr. Cullerton for his leadership of that choir. With that, we invite you to rise for the greeting. In our gathering, God's grace is abundant in creating what is new, in reconciling what is broken, and in blessing what is ahead.
Thanks be to God.
We join in the gathering song.
A reading from 1 Corinthians, the third chapter. According to the grace of God given to me, like a skilled master builder, I laid a foundation, and someone else is building on it. Each builder must choose with care how to build on it, for no one can lay any foundation other than the one that has been laid. That foundation is Jesus Christ. Now, if anyone builds on the foundation with gold, silver, precious stones, wood, hay, straw, the work of each builder will become visible, for the day will disclose it. Because it will be revealed with fire, and the fire will test what sort of work each has done. If what has been built on the foundation survives, the builder will receive a reward. If the work is burned up, the builder will suffer loss. The builder will be saved, but only as through fire. Word of God, word of life.
Thanks be to God.
Good morning. First, I would like to extend a thank you to Habitat for Humanity for giving me the opportunity to share my message with you this morning. And an additional thank you to Diana and Evan for agreeing to speak with me. My name is Maddie Gamendon, and I am a sophomore here at Concordia, a biology major with psychology and chemistry minors, and hopes of being a doctor someday. For spring break this year, I was blessed enough to be able to participate in a Habitat for Humanity trip that journeyed 17 hours to Oklahoma City, Oklahoma. This was my first time going on a habitat trip, and honestly, I didn't really know what to expect. Looking back now, it's safe to say that my first trip was full of other firsts, and that even my best predictions previous to the trip wouldn't have expected anything that actually happened. I built my first wall, I purchased my first Sonic, and then a lot more after that. I found myself brewing at my first and my last Trump rally. I will start out my message to you all in the same manner that Donald Trump started his speech at his rally, although I did not walk up to this podium to the Chicago Bulls lineup song. Here we go. Wow. Tremendous. Wow. Oy. Wow, this is great. This is great. Thank you. Unbelievable. My fellow Cobbers out there who also took IOC during their freshman year at Concordia have already taken note that this is not, in fact, ever the way you should start a speech. Although his rhetorical techniques may be lacking, his words accurately describe my Habitat for Humanity experience. I found myself saying wow a lot, as I was constantly amazed by the kindness and hard work of those around me. I also felt myself saying oi at the end of the day, as we put down our paintbrushes and hammers after a long day of hard work. The trip itself was tremendous. We were not even 5 minutes down 94 after first departing from Concordia's campus when I yelled out, "This is great!" before promptly passing out. Thank you is what I would like to say to everyone who made this trip possible, and thank you is what was said by the gracious and humble family who accepted the house key to their finished home at the end of our trip. However, the most important part of the trip for me was the community building, which was really unbelievable. Our reading today from 1 Corinthians states that we have the foundation laid down before us. Let each one take care how he builds upon it. Concordia provided a foundation through Habitat for Humanity. Our group of strangers drove to Oklahoma City with the common goal of offering our spring break for the service of others. The foundation was set. As the trip continued, the houses and community were both built. The reading from today discusses the building material that we build off the foundation with. Whatever we choose to build with will be tested. Paul states, "Now if anyone builds on the foundation with gold, silver, precious stones, hay, straw, each one's work will be tested." Each one of us contributed to the building with our own tools, a positive attitude, a hard work ethic, leadership, etc. The list never ended. The individuals on the Oklahoma Habitat for Humanity trip took care how they built upon the foundation of the community by offering the very best of their efforts. In my opinion, each one of the 15 members on our trip built our community with the very best of themselves. They built on the foundation with gold. Each and every person worked diligently and with sincere helpfulness, showed care and respect for those around them, and I am proud to call them all my friends. Our community was built through random adventures, song, a humbling bombing memorial, hard manual labor, a multitude of Sonic runs, and the acceptance of one another. Just as what is built in the reading was tested, the community that we built was tested. We struggled with gusty Oklahoma plains, hours of boring scenery in Iowa in the vans, cold weather, eating chili in a bag multiple times, dysfunctional daily brownies, schedule changes, less than adequate showering spaces, and the dreadful decision of where to eat dinner. The building of our community, our houses, was a success though. We passed the test mentioned in the reading. Eventually, we did make it out of Iowa and we got back here. The brownies got better. We were happy to help out whenever and wherever we were needed instead of just sticking to the concise schedule. We survived the Donald Trump rally and we agreed to eat anywhere as long as it wasn't Chilino's Mexican restaurant. Our Habitat for Humanity community was built through the hard work and kindness of amazing Concordia students and faculty, and the incredible experience that is a Habitat for Humanity trip. We went down to Oklahoma to build houses, but what we really built was community. This happened in many different ways, and many different moments that we all shared together as a group. Today, some of us will share just three of those special moments that made our community so strong.
As Maddie alluded to, the foundation and building of our group occurred in multiple stages, very similar to that of a house. Imagine, if you will, that process of a house. During our pre-trip meetings, we began to dig out the foundation, a crucial yet sometimes unseen first step. Our first night of the trip is when we actually poured the concrete, which would set up the rest of the trip. Only after another day or two for the concrete foundation to actually set could we begin to build the structure of our community. One of the ways that we built community on the foundation that had been laid was through song. On our second to last night in Oklahoma, a group of us decided to go exploring the church we had been staying at, First Baptist Church. So we went out exploring, in the dark, of course, and began our adventure through the labyrinth that was this church, making sure to lock each door behind us, which we had to make sure it was either the short key, long key, or the silver key, but we got it all figured out. At one point, we noticed a tall, dark figure emerge from the shadows. It was Dr. B. We made our way to the sanctuary after that, and in there we found a large balcony in the back, an elaborate organ, and the secret passageway that led to the full immersion baptismal tub. There were even two placards on a pew in the front row indicating where Vice President Lyndon B. Johnson and President John F. Kennedy once sat. Now, you're probably wondering what any of this has to do with building community through song. Well, that occurred when Maddie had an urge to sing Down to the River to Pray. And so the group took their places in the choir loft and sang, and I jumped down to the piano to provide a little accompaniment. We found some Baptist hymnals after that and began calling out hymns to sing. And the whole time, I couldn't help but think just how cool this was. A bunch of us from a good Lutheran school up there in Minnesota singing hymns in the beautiful sanctuary of First Baptist Church in Oklahoma City. It was a very exciting and positive experience, so much so that it was many of our highs of the day the following night, a full 24 hours later. I guess it makes sense that our building block was not that of some of the tangible gold, silver, precious stones, wood, hay, or straw, but rather that of song, something a little less tangible, yet just as supporting. I now turn it back to Maddie to share a slightly more somber block of our community.
So Evan shared a little bit of a happy moment, and I'm gonna share a little bit more serious one. On April 19, 1995, Oklahoma City experienced a domestic terrorist bomb attack on an FBI building, which killed and wounded hundreds and damaged over 324 buildings on a 16-block radius. Our group members took not one, but many walks to the site of this bombing and what is now a magnificent and humbling memorial. The small collection of Cobbers was suddenly part of a much larger community of Oklahoma City, one that had built their community back through grieving, heartache, and the suffering that had taken place there. To walk through the memorial and see the toys that were left in memory of children that had died, or the pieces of destroyed building that are left as reminders, is to experience some of that very real anguish. In the memorial, we also came across the survivor tree, which stands today as a reminder that we are all Americans and that we survived hardships by supporting one another and building our community back. For our group, the Oklahoma bombing memorial forced us to take a step back from our tight-knit Cobber community and even the Oklahoma City community and face the tragedies that are still occurring all around our American community. The violence, anger, and hurt are still occurring all around our nation. Several of us reflected on 9/11, school shootings, and other horrors that are still happening today. The memorial served as a tool for building community through honor, respect, and the promise to always continuing remembering. Community is not always built in an easier, joyful way, but it is strong, uniting, and built through overcoming hardships with love.
Like Maddie had previously mentioned, and the quote from earlier, going on this trip included tools, and they weren't always just physical tools, but rather tools of personality. When we got in the vans on the very first day, a few of us knew each other, but quite frankly, at times it was awkward and quiet. But by the second or third day, we all began to realize that each of us had this one tool in common, and that was that we were all there to help build, clean, paint, or do whatever job that they wanted us to do. And we weren't doing it just to build houses, but also to build friendships and relationships with other people. We weren't always experienced with the tools we were given. For example, they gave me a nail gun and a saw, and it seemed scary to be exposed to such a big responsibility and opportunity at times, but we became accustomed to our tools and used them to let our personalities shine more and more, and we were truly able to build not only houses, but those friendships out of gold. Along with this, we were given the opportunity to not only see the houses being built as we built our community up, but we were also given other odd jobs. On the first day of working, it was raining, and we were put inside a home to paint the walls white. And a lot of us were disappointed at first, since we were looking forward so much to building these houses. But after the painting was complete that day, we got to experience meeting part of the family that was going to be living there, and experience how happy and grateful they truly were. They say God works in mysterious ways, because what could have been the most disappointing day of work quickly turned into one of the best. We were all making jokes with each other, getting paint all over our clothes and in our hair, and towards the end, we even got invited to the house dedication that would be at the end of the week. After seeing the look on the family's faces, I can say that we not only built with this gold, silver, precious jewels, but we painted with gold, cleaned with gold, and we built a secure home for the family. Each day, God gives us the tools and the foundation we need to succeed and help others. All we need to do is be open-minded and go into it with a loving heart.
For those that are hearing me speak, but have never partaken in a Habitat for Humanity trip, it is an adventure that you will want to take, and a community that you will want to build. For some, a Habitat trip will be like a Donald Trump rally. You really only need to go once, and you get the full experience. For others, Habitat for Humanity will be more like a Sonic trip. Once you get your first taste, you have to keep going back again and again and again. When signups come up next spring, I hope you consider signing up, both to build houses and community. However, this isn't the only community that you can focus on building. We are all a part of this Concordia community and the Fargo-Moorhead community, and I hope that when you build your community, you build with the very best of yourself, and you better those around you. I also hope that when you build, you remember the words of our reading today, and you build off the foundation that has been laid down before you. Paul tells us that we have a choice to build on the foundation God laid down before us, the life of Jesus in place of our sins. We also have the choice of what to build with, and during this Lenten season especially, take time to reflect on the tools you are using to build your life. Will you build upon the foundation of faith with important qualities of gold, silver, and precious stones? Will what you add to the foundation be strong enough to stand a test of time or the hardships we encounter? Often during Lent, we put in extra efforts to reflect, give back, and improve the life of others of faith, but our efforts should continue after Lent. They should stand that test of time. There is never a time when we should stop thriving to be better and adding to our foundation. So whether in Habitat for Humanity, community, or faith, I hope you keep building. Thank you.
Oh, rooted in Christ and service, let us pray for the church, the world, and all in need. God of glory, guide and empower your church's leaders to trust your promises and look only to you. Shine the light of Christ through your church to the world. Equip us with compassion and boldness to listen to our neighbors. Make our speech and actions witness to your eternal presence. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
God of creation, you made every living creature and saw that it was good. Cultivate in all people a care for the world you have made. Make us mindful of our impact on creation for the good of our neighbor and future generations. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
God of justice, we pray for all those around the world who lack their basic needs. Grant peace of heart and mind to those who are hungry and homeless, and those who lack adequate education and health care. Give the spirit of righteousness to work for justice, equality, and fairness. Sustain community leaders, legislators, volunteers, peacemakers, and all who seek the good of their communities. Lord, in your mercy. God of kindness, you tend your flock with mercy and love. Guide the outreach ministries of Concordia College. Strengthen our relationship in our many communities as we seek to serve our neighbors in love. Lord, in your mercy. To you, gracious God, we commend all for whom we pray, trusting in your boundless mercy, through Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. Amen. Now let us pray the prayer our Lord has taught us to pray. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Please stand to receive the blessing. The God of all grace, who has called you to new life in Christ, restore, support, strengthen, and bless you by the power of the Holy Spirit, now and forever. We join in the sending song. Peace, serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.